Hi friends, welcome to our channel Multimedia of Science. Today I am discussing about the topic incomplete dominance. I am already mentioned about that of the dominance by Mendel. So the continuous section from that chapter, Principles of Inheritance and Variation, the part 2 section. Welcome to this. Let's start. First, we are talking about incomplete dominance, and this incomplete dominance was discovered by that of the Carl Correns. Then the incomplete dominance, Mendel's law of dominance. The law of dominance is by that of the Mendel, and it is not universally applicable for all plants. So some plants are not obeying this law, and for example, they are included in that of the incomplete dominance. So example for this incomplete dominance is Mirabilis jalapa. Mirabilis jalapa, that is 4 o'clock plant. 4 o'clock plant. Then next is Andirhinum majus. Andirhinum majus. That is snapdragon or dog flower. Snapdragon or dog flower. Here we get the ratio of 1:2:1, both genotypical ratio and phenotypical ratio. So both genotypical ratio and phenotypical ratio is same in the case of incomplete dominance. Okay, one homozygous and two is heterozygous. That is the ratio. Clear? The Carl Correns cause a red flower. Here, for example, we can show. That is, if a red plant is crossed with that of the another one, which is what? Yeah, small letter R. Okay. And this cross to give what? Red versus white. To give what? Pink color, which means it does not shows the color of red, or it does not shows the color of white, neither these, but here forming as another color, which is pink. Okay, how it is formed? Yeah, it is in F1 generation. Then what is formed in that of the F2 generation? We already discussed how we get that of the F2 generation by self fertilization of this F1 generation. So R, capital R, small r, capital R, small r. Write the gamete. Cross it. R. Capital R, small r, capital R, small r, small r, small r. Here, what we getting? Yes, homozygous. These two are heterozygous. So it is red, white, and pink. These two are pink. So 1:2:1. Hope that it is clear for you. Okay. Where here heterozygous condition, that is capital R small r gene, here R gene is unable to suppress that of the small r gene completely. So both the genes together express their character, and this character should be average of both red and white. So it is pink in color. This is called what? Incomplete dominance. Neither the red color nor the white color, and it shows that of the pink color. Clear? That is called what? Incomplete dominance. Next we are dealing with, this is about the incomplete dominance. Please note these points. Next is about what? Multiple alleles. So our next topic is multiple alleles. According to that of the Mendel, a character has only two alleles. But later, this concept was changed. Certain characters like blood group, okay, certain character like blood group are example for this multiple allelism, and they have more than two allele. So blood group are of the four types, which are they? Yeah, we always know that A, B, AB and O. These are different type, four types of the blood groups, which are common. And this grouping is based on the presence or absence of some glycoprotein, or we can say that antigen, okay, placed on the membrane of RBC. So these are varying on the basis of that of the presence or absence of the glycoprotein. What? The glycoprotein or antigen, which is present on the surface of the RBC. Clear? This is RBC. Surface of this RBC. A presence or absence which indicates that of this different type of the blood group. Clear? And here there are two type of the A and B. That is antigen A. Clear? The antigen A is produced by the dominant gene IA. And next is about antigen B, that is produced by a dominant gene of IB. Here the small I is recessive, okay, small I is recessive, and which cannot produce any antigen. Clear? Which cannot produce any antigen. Here IA and IB are dominant over this small I. So these two are more dominant. And this is recessive. Clear? So IA and IB are co-dominant, and that is equally dominant. So we can write this like IA equal to IB, which means equally dominant. And these are what? Co-dominant. So their combination produce both A and B antigen. Here the blood group have three allele. So it is an example for what? Multiple allelism. The Mendel proposed about that of the two allele system, but here the multiple allelism prove that it is of three allele system. Clear? While we considering that of the blood group, antigen, antibody and genotype, we can go through a small table. So the blood group, then antigen, antibody, next is about their genotype, corresponding genotype. So first is about the blood group A. If A is our blood group, then the antigen present in it should be A, and then antibody, it is small b. Then what is genotype? Yeah, two genotype are possible, IA IA or IA and small I, which is recessive. The next is about capital letter B blood group, then antigen present B and antibody small a. Then what is the corresponding genotype? IB IB and IB I. If the AB blood group is present there, if AB blood group is present, then the antigen is AB, antibody is not present, so we can write it as nil. Then IA, IB is the genotype, which is called what? Codominance. Next is about the O blood group. Okay, the O blood group have no antigen, so nil. Then what is about their antibody? Yeah, antibody is present, A and B. Then genotype, what? Yeah, recessive, II. So in multiple allelism, the character has some phenotype and genotype. What is about their genotype and phenotype? Yeah, so please remember this point, that is in multiple allelism, in multiple allelism. What is present? Yes, 4 phenotype and 6 genotype. 4 phenotype and 6 genotype are present. Okay, that is about multiple allelism. Okay, I'm concluding this. Then next our video is about the questions from these incomplete dominance, dominance, recessive, multiple allelism and monohybrid cross. So please watch that video also. I will done it is in next day. Okay, thank you.